So in this tutorial, we're going to be going over how to add PBR textures to absolutely any model in Blender. And of course, before we do this, we need to make sure we have some of these textures downloaded. So in my case, I'm going to get them from my own website, which is cgmatter.com. You can get textures from absolutely anywhere. In this case, I'm just going to be using my own. I'm going to use this right here. And then we get these seamless textures for free, at least on this website. And I'm gonna download 2K version, and then once you do this, it's gonna eventually start downloading. Of course, mine is already downloaded here, and you're gonna get a ambient occlusion, base color, height, metallic, normal, and roughness maps. And we wanna know how to add these into a material in Blender. So we can actually close this right here. So how do we add this to our cube? So we're gonna start off by going to shading, and we want to have a HDRI so we have some lighting going on. So I'm going to change this to world. And I already made a tutorial on how to add an HDRI, so I'm going to do it quickly, but I'll try to explain it. We're going to close this. We're going to click Shift A, which is going to let us add a texture, environment texture. We're going to connect this to the surface of the world. And then we're going to open any HDRI you already have downloaded. In this case, I'll be using this one. And then here we go. Now we actually want to work on the material of the cube. So how do we do that? So what you want to do is go over to Object, and by default, you should already have a principled BSDF with an output set up. If you don't, you can close whatever material you have, click New, and it will show up. If for some reason you don't like that, you can just hit Shift A, go to Shader, and then add a principled BSDF shader right here. And then you have the same thing, connect those, and we're back to square one. Okay, so how do we connect all these maps? So we're gonna go in some kind of order. So first of all, ambient occlusion. This one is special because we actually do not need it in Blender. This is pretty much calculated on render in cycles and in Eevee. This is more for game engine, so we don't actually use this. So we're gonna start with base color. We're just gonna drag this in. And of course, base color is gonna be the color of the cube. So we're gonna take this color and connect it to base color. And there we go, it's showing up. Next, what we want to do is we're going to go to metallic. We're going to drag this in. And then one special thing about metallic is you don't want to necessarily take this and just connect it to metallic, because you need to make sure this right here, this color, is set to non-color data. And that's because a metallic map is basically supposed to be values between 0 and 1, not necessarily the color data. Okay, so we have that. Next, we're gonna go over to roughness, which same business. We're gonna take it, we're gonna connect it to roughness, but we wanna set this color to non-color data because we want values between 0 and 1. Okay. Next we have, let's see, we can do normal and height. And for these, we kind of combine them in a special way. I'll show you how. So we're gonna take our normal map, bring them in here. We are gonna take our height map. Some people call it a displacement map. These things are generally the same. And then we put this right here. Okay, so we have these two maps. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to set both of these to non-color data. This is very important. If you don't do this, it's going to look very bizarre. Okay, now what we need is a bump node. So you just click Shift A. And in here you can type bump, or you can try to find it. I think it's in vector bump. Okay, and then in this bump, we see we have a normal input and a height input. So it's pretty obvious what you do. Take this height, or no, this one's the height. Take the height and put it in height. And note that this normal input is purple while this one is yellow. This is indicating that this is just a image. It's a texture. It's not a normal map. So what we have to do is convert it. So Shift A, and then here you can either type normal map or go to vector and add a normal map node. We're going to take this, connect it. So now we have a normal map, and then we're going to connect this in here. And then finally, we take this bump node, connect it into our normal socket. Okay, it's going to take a second, and already it's looking much more 3D. Now, let's say that this is like, these bricks are too big, you want them to tile smaller, so you want more tiles. So the question is, how do you do this? What we're going to do is we're going to take each of our image inputs, and we're going to line them up. Take these three, shift them over. Whoops, I accidentally shifted over this one too. And what we want to do is basically change the mapping so that we add twice as much or three times as many bricks here. So what we want to do, Shift A, and then you want to add a couple things. So you're going to start off with a mapping node. So go to Vector, Mapping, and then you're going to connect this vector to each of these. So that's going to be a couple of connections. Whoops. Let me close that. connect this here. A bit of work, but overall less work than making a shader from scratch. So we're going to connect all of these. Okay, so now we have this mapping node and we're going to want to change the size. But before we do that, we need to add a coordinate input. So you're going to click Shift A, and then I believe it is in input, texture coordinates, and then it depends on what coordinates you're using. Most of the time you use UV maps, so we're going to be using a UV map. There are cases where you use other things, but in this case, R cube, if you go to UV editing, you see that it's already UV mapped, so that's why we're using that. Okay, so now we have this coordinate going into this mapping, which is going into all our textures, which are doing their respective things. Okay, so how do we actually affect this? Well, you just drag the scale and you see what it's doing already. So let's double it in both directions. There we go. And I don't actually know what the Z does. I think it's irrelevant to this case. Yeah, it doesn't do anything. At least I don't think it does anything. Let's see. Yeah, it doesn't do anything. If we want even more tiles, again, this is seamless, so it's going to work out. We can have triple as many, so three times, and then this is how you do it. And of course, we have a seam along here because there's a seam in our UV map here. But generally, this is how you do it. And just to see the full effects, by the way, we've been using Eevee this whole time, but again, this setup for Eevee is identical to that of Cycles. We just switched this over to Cycles, and you see that everything is working. Change this to GPU compute, goes a bit faster on my computer, and you see it's already working here. And if you want to see this lighting change around so you can really see the depth into bricks and all this, go back to World, and we're going to do a similar setup here. So with our HDRI, we're going to add a mapping. This time I'm just going to type it in. Add our mapping. And then we're going to add some coordinates. So input, texture coordinate, and in this case, I'm pretty sure we use generated, not UV. So that's an instance where we use generated. Okay, and this is actually a case where we use our Z input. I can like rotate this like that, and then you see the lighting is changing. It takes a bit because it cycles. We can actually just go back to Eevee like that, and then we can get a more fluid motion. And by the way, as I said, we don't need ambient occlusion maps. Cycles obviously does it, but Eevee, you just click ambient occlusion, and you see these gaps in between the bricks automatically get their ambient occlusion. So this is how you do PBR in Blender. So again, we do not use ambient occlusion unless you want to do some like very weird stylistic thing. It's not physically accurate. You don't want to use it. Base color goes in base color. Let's see, metallic goes in metallic, but set this to non-color. Roughness and roughness, set it to non-color. You take your normal and height and change your normal into a normal map and then feed them both into a bump and then put this in our normal socket. And then we can always change our tiling using these. And then one final note is with this bump map, you can actually control how much this thing is, at least looks like it's extruding. So we can change the strength here, and you can see how that works. Generally, you want to keep this at one unless your textures aren't pre-calibrated to already be like exactly what you want. So again, I used textures from cgmatter.com. Textures for free if you want them there. I mean, it's an advertisement for my own site, but it's free, so consider it maybe. So hopefully this helped. Thank you for watching, and hope you learned something.